Hi friends, as we have seen that quantization process introduces noise in the signal. So what is the SNR of this signal? Whether it is good or bad? And on what factor does it depend on? So we are going to see what do you mean by signal to quantization noise ratio. So as we know that it is signal to quantization noise ratio, the SNR for an A to D converter is nothing but the power input, the input power, which we denote as the variance of input, divided by the power of the error signal. Okay, it is nothing but the power ratio of input to the noise power or the error power. Now, normally SNRs are represented in dB. So SNRs, which is SNR, which is of A to D, which is in dB, is given as 10 log to the base 10 of sigma x square by sigma e square. Now, what is sigma x square and what is sigma e square? Sigma x square is the variance of the input random process, and sigma e square is the variance of the noise process. So we know that sigma e, okay, if we consider it to be wide sense stationary, okay, a random process, and if it is uniformly distributed, then the variance of sigma e is delta square by 12. Okay, this is the value. If you wanted to know about this value, how it comes up, then you have to visit the video on A to D conversion noise. Okay, but here I will directly use the result or which is derived in the video of A to D converter noise, okay, or quantization noise. So we will be directly using this relation. We also know that, okay, RFS and delta is also related, and delta can be written as minus B plus 1 into RFS, okay, because RFS is a delta, RFS is 2 delta into 2 raised to B plus 1, okay. So this is what the relation of delta with RFS. RFS stands for full scale range. Therefore, I can write sigma e square to be equal to, okay, I can take this down, and okay, we will need to square it. So let us square it. So it will be 2 raised to minus b plus 1 into RFS the whole square by 12. So I solve it here. It becomes the square when comes inside becomes 2 raised to minus 2b. And this I can write it as minus 2 raised to minus 2, isn't it? So this becomes 2 raised to minus 2b into 2 raised to minus 2 into RFS square divided by 12. So this 2 raised to minus 2 can be brought down. It will be 2, it will be 4. So 4 into 12 will be 48. So it will be 2 raised to minus 2b into RFS the whole square divided by 48. Okay, so that is sigma e square. Okay, that I will be using in my formula to derive the SNR. Therefore, I can write SNR of an A to D converter in dB is given as, okay, 10 log to the base 10. Okay, now in the numerator I have sigma x square. I'll write sigma x square divided by denominator. I have sigma e square, where sigma e square is 2 raised to minus 2b RFS the whole square divided by 48. I'll take 48 up, and that becomes 10 log to the base 10, 48 sigma x square divided by 2 raised to minus 2b into RFS the whole square, isn't it? Now what I'll do is I'll take the 10 log inside and do the adjustment. Therefore, the total SNR of A to D converter in dB can be written as 6.02B plus 16.81 minus 20 log to the base 10, RFS by sigma x dB. Okay, what I did is 10 log to the base 10 of 48 I have taken, then sigma x square and RFS was combined together, and I have written it in the minus. That is how I have done, is bringing this sigma x square in the denominator, and 2 raised to minus 2b can be taken as 10 log, that 2b will come in the front side, and which will be minus 2 raised to minus b, and then taking the log of 2 with respect to b and then adjusting, it will give me this value. So the final equation after solving this 10 log will be this. So this will be the total SNR, which we see that it depends on the number of bits we are using for representation. The full scale range of the system and the random process or the input random process. So if I increase the sigma, if I increase the power of the input, it might help us. Yeah, it will help us. But if I increase the number of bits, of course the SNR will go up. That has also been observed over here. So this is how we derive a signal to noise or quantization noise ratio of an A to D converter. Thank you.